Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today's Down and Dirty. We're going to be covering another machine control system. This is called the iDig system. It is a French company. They're relatively new to the American market, and they have graciously offered to let Rick and I play with their system for a week. And so I wanted to make a series of videos to kind of walk you guys through the system and give you some kind of fundamentals, as I always do in these videos, of how to use it. So today we're going to talk about kind of the screen and the information presented and where to find things. I do have a separate video on kind of hooking the system up and what's involved with that. You can click up above to watch that video. Unfortunately, due to time constraints, I'm not going to be able to make a video on the calibration of the system, but I will say, even though Kevin from iDig was here, I did not use him during the calibration portion. I told him I wanted to see if I could walk through it by myself, and I was easily able to do that. This system is very, very user-friendly, and it was super, super straightforward. All of your calibration tools come in the kit when you purchase the iDig system. So even if I wanted to take the system off of this machine and transfer it to another machine, I already in my kit have the calibration tools that I need to get that set up, and the whole process to calibrate takes about 15 to 20 minutes. It's really straightforward. I think once you did it a few times, you could actually get that time down a little bit. So all that to say, we're not going to have a video on that, but it is really, really straightforward. So now let's kind of get into the iDig system. So we have a light bar that is our actual indicator that we're going to be reading, just like you would in a dozer or another excavator with machine control. This is our indicate system on where we're at in relation to grade. Here we have our screen, which is our interface. This is a touch screen. This is where we're going to do all of our things. So let's just kind of go around the screen really fast. The 4.1 feet is how far we are from grade. And I don't want you to focus on that, because that is an arbitrary point that we're going to kind of, you'll see as we go into the video. You don't need to worry about that, because that's just an arbitrary number right now. We have our straight on view of our bucket. We have our side profile of the bucket. You also have a measurement reading to grade from where our bucket is there. And then you have your buttons across the bottom. Starting with this little red laser looking with a lock, that is where we would actually, if we had a laser set up, we could use our stick sensor and actually catch that laser, and that is where we would go in and do that. We will do a separate video on that process. The next button over, which looks like a little slope with a percentage, I bet you can guess what that's for. If you guessed it's for doing slopes, you are correct. If I tap that, you'll see we can do a single slope or a dual slope. Again, we'll get into that with a separate video. Pretend I didn't click there. I don't want to get you all scared of all the buttons. The next button over is, let's say we were in a situation to where I wanted to dig 3 foot down over here and 1 foot down over here before I move the machine. This is a button where you can easily bump your grade up and down. That's what that does. The next one over, before we establish a grade, you're not going to see this icon that I'm covering with my finger. That will not be there. So these will be the four buttons that you see before you establish a grade. So we're only going to talk about this one for now. It's the two little lines with the pencil. So what that is, let's say right here is ground level, which it is, and we want to dig 3 feet below that. So what I've done, by the way, you're going to notice, this is one of my only complaints about this system. Every once in a while you get question marks up here, our light bar flashes, and you see a little dial up here pop up. For whatever reason, we're losing connection every once in a while with the stick sensor. I don't know why. It's kind of sporadic, but it will reestablish itself within 5 to 10 seconds, and then we're back online. So just FYI, that's what that was. So again, here's ground level. We want to dig 3 feet below that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click this pencil, and it says, hey, I don't know what your actual is right now. What's our new? And so if I wanted this to be my grade, I could just say, hey, this is my 0 point. And you can see now that my bucket is on grade. But in our situation, we want to dig 3 feet below that. So what we're going to do is we're going to click this, and we're going to say, nope, this is actually 3 feet above grade. That's our new number. And sure enough, now you can see we are 3 feet above grade. So now if I start digging, we will have a grade indicator when we get 3 foot down, and it's going to carry it level across. Now we get into this button here. So let's pretend for a second, and I'm gonna move around, I'm gonna discombobulate everybody, and I'm sorry, I apologize, but this is what happens when you do training videos and not actually working. All right, so we're gonna rebench to that point right there. We're gonna zero out. And when I put zero, it zeroes out to what number we put in here. So you can see it zeroed out to this being 3 foot above grade. So let's go check and see how far we actually are down here. Look at that, we're within a half 10. So let's pretend that we just dug this trench and now we're at grade. Boom, look at that, we did so awesome. That's great. And now we wanna move our machine. But now because we moved our machine and all of our sensors are off, this is the difference between a 2D and a 3D system. Because our sensors are off, the machine doesn't know where grade is. It just knows that where our bucket is in relation to our tracks should be 5/10 above grade. So we need to actually re-zero our system on grade here. And so that's where, first of all, we know that's grade now, so we're gonna change this to our actual being zero, because that's grade. So now we dig, we back up again. Wrong way. And so now I need to reset the machine and tell it, hey, this is where grade is. So I reach back out here to my point that I know is grade, and I'm just feeling I'm touching the ground right there. I'm touching the ground. Now I just hit this button, boom. I'm re-zeroed, and I can continue digging. And it's going to continue to carry that grade. So that's what that button does, is once we've established grade, instead of having to go in and type a number every time, it's just a very quick zero point. But when I say zero point, it's important to understand we are zeroing back to whatever our height was that we established, or our cut was originally. So if I put 5 feet in here, and then we move all over the place, and I re-zero, you can see it resets to this being 5 feet. So that's an important concept. We do have a button here in the corner. This is all of our settings. So we can go into basic settings where we can change the language. We can go in and actually look at the status of our sensors, which I actually had to do. We had some issues with one of our sensors earlier in the week, and I had to go in here and look at this. You can change the units, which I have done as well, because in fact, I am going to change this. We had a slope ratio of 4:1, and so I needed to be able to plug that in. But today we're gonna be using percentage slope. So I'm gonna change that over, I'm gonna apply, and then we're gonna get back out. You can change brightness, you can change all sorts of settings within this menu. You can go into system settings. This is where you can actually change the functionality of things. You can add buckets, you can add up to 100 attachments per machine, and you can have up to 100 machines in the system. So if I took this screen and my light bar and everything, transferred it to my mini excavator, and I have 8 buckets for my mini excavator, all I would do, I can go to select machines, I can select any of my machines, then I can go down and select any of the buckets for that machine, and then I'm good to go. So that's a really cool feature as well. Finally, we have some work settings here. This is where you can start getting into whether you want an audible alarm. The system will beep at you like a grade rod if you like that feature. If you want to have alarms go off when you reach inside or outside a certain area, you can set that up. You can also change the sensitivity so that the thing's not bouncing all over on the screen all the time. That's where you can change that. Now we get into some other buttons that pop up here when I tap on the screen. So we get into some tools here. So the first one is a measurement tool. So I can actually, I'm gonna tap our measuring tool. And let's just say I wasn't in position. Now I wanna measure from this point. All I'm gonna do, you can see we have our measurement, and I'm sorry guys, that sun is killing me on this demonstration here. So now that we're out of the sun, let me get the bucket out of the way. So now, you can see we've got an arbitrary number in there because I tapped the measuring tool and then I moved all over. Let's say I want to measure from that spot right there. I'm just going to click to zero that out, and then I can move, and it gives me all my measurements. really cool feature. So we can tap to zero, or if I tap the actual measuring tape, it goes away. The next button down is an overhead obstruction. So what this does, I'm gonna tap it. It takes our boom. Let's say we had a power line up here. If I tap this, it's gonna give me a warning and say, hey, this is not controlling the machine. It's not gonna stop you from getting into the power lines. This is literally just a tool to keep you from getting yourself into trouble. So what it will do is it will flash at you, and I don't know, this is where I haven't played with, I'm just gonna be honest, I have not played with that feature enough to figure out how to set it up correctly. But what happens is, when you get high enough and you start getting into that zone that you said, hey, I don't wanna go any higher, mind you, it's an indicate only tool, it's not gonna stop your machine, but it will start flashing and flashing the light bar at you saying, hey, you're getting into something you said you didn't wanna get into. So that is what that button is there. The next thing we have is a horizontal component. So let's say we only wanted to dig to this point right here. We could turn on this measurement here, and now we have a horizontal component. And you're going to notice that this portion of our light bar is now working. And so as we come closer to our point, notice our light bar, boom. And so now we have not only the horizontal indicator here, we also on our light bar have a horizontal indicator of that point that we established that we only want to dig up to. And that's how you set that up. And then if we want to cancel that out, we just hit this little X here. Whoops, only one time. And there you go. The next button coming up to the top here, we can change our view. We can have just the single bucket view. We can have picture in picture, swap the picture in picture, or our traditional view. Then we can actually zoom in and out, and that will adjust our sensitivity because of the scale. And then we can reset our scale with that middle button. Finally, all the way on the right hand side here, this is a sensor. This is all of the sensors on the machine. You can look at the battery indicator levels of the ones, all of our sensors out here on the stick, I've talked about this in another video, are all wireless, and they are all photo cells that charge them. So they charge off of sunlight. So we can check our status indicator here. We can verify that they are actually reading correctly from this screen. And so this is kind of a diagnostic screen here. So that's kind of an overview of the iDig system. Again, this is super fast, super high level, because this is already going to be a lengthy video. We are going to do videos on setting slopes and taking benchmarks and doing all of that, so stay tuned for those videos. As always, I hope this has been helpful for you guys, and we'll catch you on the next video.